Who would have thought the end of the world could be so peaceful?
At least until night falls.
True. I wish Crane could have seen this.
Who?
Doesn't matter. I tracked down that guy for you.
What guy?
Quit pretending. You became a pilgrim to track that fucker down. Waltz, I found someone who knows him.
Wait, what? And you're only telling me now?
When I tossed you a beer, thought you'd guess right away we were celebrating. The guy's in Villador. Supposedly he knows something about Waltz.
Villador. So I'm that close, huh?
Nigga!
Civilization is a vulnerable thing, a whim of circumstance. At any time, the smallest flap of a butterfly's wings may set catastrophe in motion. Haran, an entire city wiped from the map. Those left behind there did not stand a chance. The world's greatest minds came together and found a vaccine against the Haran virus. Finally, mankind had prevailed against the disease. But people always want more. Despite a promise to shutter its labs, the GRE continued its research in secrecy for military purposes. It didn't take long for a variant of THV to escape into the world once more. The fall happened more rapidly than anyone could have predicted. The few who survived now live in small enclaves. The only means of contact between distant human settlements are lone individuals, brave or desperate enough to travel on their own across dangerous wastelands. They are known as pilgrims. Somewhere on the map, one city is still standing. A city isolated from the outside world. A city with special rules. Now, it's the last bastion of humanity. Chance for us to learn from history. And for once, make the right choices. Because every choice you make here shapes the future. Irreversibly.
still got it.
You know, this game used to be more fun.
And you used to be younger.
And dumber.
What matters is, you're still just as fast. Because a slow pilgrim
is a
dead
pilgrim. Yeah, I know.
Get up here. I want to show you something. Shit, man. You're still strong.
Thanks. Good to see you, Spike. I mean, how long has it been?
Far too long. But don't get all mushy on me now. Come, I want to show you something.
Where are we going?
You'll see. It's incredible.
What's incredible?
Most pilgrims don't last 2-3 years on the road. How you've been kicking around for what, 4 years now? And you're still alive.
So are you.
I know, but I'm fucking awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
Seriously, I wish I had as much energy as you. Got a new lead on Jane?
Nah, trail went cold after New Paris.
Which route did you take? Through Baines or Gary?
Baines. What a shithole. Some 5 rickety huts left and a ramshackle fence.
Look at that. A beehive full of honey. Can't let an opportunity like this go to waste.
No way.
Oh, look around. If we're lucky, there's chamomile growing here, too. You know what chamomile looks like, right?
Yeah, this'll do.
You remember that old herbalist we helped escort to her village?
Oh, yeah, the one that had that saying, remember, chamomile and honey are gifts that keep giving.
Combine them and lucky you, you just might go on living. Come on, we're almost there.
Yeah.
This is it. Come on.
Wow.
Somebody had a nice crib. Damn it, locked. I'll try to get through here. You check the other side. Take anything we could use.
Yeah, sure. Empty. Nothing here. Nothing in here. What the?
Hey, everything all right?
Yeah, just rats.
I think it's time we parted ways.
Why?
I'm starting to worry about you. And you know our saying, if you're starting to worry about someone, it means it's time to go.
Party. But by then the GRE would have long since lost control of the virus. I wonder how the wine tasted back then. Who do you voodoo? Sounds familiar. And that's what they called art? Thank you. Nada. Zip. It's heartbreaking.
There's nothing like a party to celebrate the end of the world.
They died on their own terms.
Let's hope we get that lucky too. I'll see what's upstairs. You check out the garden, okay?
Okay. At least they had each other. She was classy. Dearest Mary, I'm sorry I ran from you. They say that once the virus makes you turn, you're gone forever. That can't be true. I know you're still in there, underneath all that pain and disease. I'm coming to join you. No more running. God.
Abe, come here. Check this out.
Sit down, buddy. For you.
A gift?
A gift from the heavens, to be more accurate. I've just found it, by the owner's dead body. May it be of more use to you. Here.
It's gone flat.
Look at you and your sophisticated palate. Drink. Who would have thought the end of the world could be so peaceful?
Yeah, at least until night falls.
True. wish Crane could have seen this.
Who?
Doesn't matter. I tracked down that guy for you.
Hey, what guy?
Quit pretending. You became a pilgrim to track that fucker down. Waltz. I found someone who knows him.
Wait, what? And you're only telling me now?
When I tossed you a beer, thought you'd guess right away we were celebrating. The guy's in Villador. Supposedly he knows something about Waltz.
Villador. So I'm that close, huh? I got a favor to ask you. You deliver this to Gary? It's on your way. People don't like pilgrims there, but they pay well.
And where do people like pilgrims?
Well, they're afraid of us. Everyone does their best to survive.
Maybe. But when something needs to be transported through the hordes of infected, then suddenly they're knocking on our doors. All right. But you owe me one.
Not just one. So, what about that guy?
Well, I talked to him over the radio. He didn't tell me his name. Sounds like he's got something to hide. See that antenna on the hill? That'll help you contact the informant. He'll be listening for you at dawn on a frequency of 140.200 megahertz. Told him he'd hear from you soon.
What does he want in return?
Didn't say. But he didn't sound like the kind of guy who does things for free.
I don't think that kind of guy exists.
What? What about me?
You're an old fart who likes racing me, and makes me ask around about his crazy girlfriend.
Hey. She's not crazy. Jane's just maybe, well, a little hot-headed. And she's always getting herself into trouble. But if you could get a load of her...
Whoa, all right. Still too early in the evening for that sort of talk.
Eyes? I was going to say eyes. Beautiful. Steely. Huge.
Never heard anyone get so worked up about gray eyes.
Because you don't know shit about the world, let alone women.
Yeah, you're probably right.
I'm telling you, I'll finally find Jane. We'll set up a house. We're going to live there. No one's going to drive us out. And I'll stop wondering like a moron.
I'll drink to that.
And that Waltz. What's his deal? Is he family?
No. Not at all.
Then why are you looking for him? Will you tell me sometime?
Yeah. Yeah, one day.
Well, my time's up.
So when will I see you again, huh? In another 2 years?
Maybe. Take care, man. I hope you find that Waltz guy, or whoever you're looking for. And remember, 140.200 megahertz. At dawn, the guy's waiting for you.
Thank you.
spiders.
Yeah.
Almost there. Oh, it's already dark. It's time to hide somewhere for the night. It won't get any better than this. Broadcast station should be here somewhere. Thank you. Okay, let's give it a try. This is it. The broadcast station. I gotta start the generator. Oh, it's dead. I need to connect it to power.
Yeah! Like, now?
No, when we're old. Now, 80.
We need supplies.
Everything's ready.
It's so quiet. Where is everyone?
Maybe they're all dead.
You're stupid.
Let's go. Now.
Shh. It'll be all right.
Wait here. Nothing good will come of this.
Have you brought 12346?
We were supposed to take the patients back to the city.
Don't worry. They'll let us go soon.
Edie, I'm scared.
I'm here with you. You're safe with me. Separate us, this is how we'll always find each other.
Dr. Waltz, we won't make it. The military will be here any moment.
Wait. Close your eyes.